Kia ora and welcome to Fresh. Today you're with some of the legends of Pacific sports. Alan's ripping it up on the sports field.
My first coming up on Fresh today.
I haven't done too bad. Been given an opportunity to fight some of the greats in the game and I've done pretty good against them.
You like what you see? I'm a man of steel.
Like the legend of the Phoenix, yeah. All ends with beginnings. It keeps the planet spinning. The force from the beginning.
Oh, hey, freshies. Hey, how are you? You found me. So, where am I? I don't know. I'm just coming here and see all these sporting legends, night. Maybe some kind of sports function. Let's go look for some food, isn't it? Yeah, let's go.
Okay.
Oh! Can you tell us who is your most favourite Pacific Island sports person?
Probably Steve Adams, just because of the success that he's got.
I'll have to be Fitz.
Peter Fadiello for the big prop forward. He's on his way, and he gets there.
Hang on, Tringa Mala.
I'm going to say David Chua.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Oscar Kiley, and when I'm not lighting up the stadiums of the world being a sports star, I like to hear about other talented islanders who are doing well in the music scene in Australia. So ladies and gents and everything in between, here are the Fortunates.
Hey guys, we are Fortunate.
My name is Joe.
I'm Zaya.
I'm Q.
And I'm Jay.
We all bring something different to the table, I guess. Me personally, I'm the one who just looks after our style, I guess. You have to have your good shoes on.
I'm Zaya. I am 21. I look after the arrangements, music arrangements and stuff with Shaquille.
Would you let me see beneath your beautiful?
My name is Shaquille, I'm 19. My role in the group, I'm just overlook everything and make sure behind the scenes stuff is getting done.
He also takes care of a lot of our Corey for live shows as well, so.
Yeah. I try my best to Corey. I know all you New Zealanders are amazing dancers, so I didn't want to say that. Nah.
I'm Jay. I am 18. I'm the youngest of the group. I'd say my role in the group is to look after our health.
Making
sure we're eating well, drinking our smoothies.
Yes.
Three of us are brothers, 1, 2, 3, and Joe's just a good friend of ours. He was auditioning for X Factor, as were we, and we just formed the group.
Tonight we're opening for the amazing Sammy J.
Yeah, it's just a blessing to be here and to be amongst great talent.
Why don't you get on the floor?
Where are we at?
First in Wales.
Who are we here to see?
Sammy J.
We're here at Sammy J's concert. We're here to watch Fortunate.
Fortunate came into the mix last year when they performed in X Factor. They just dropped their first single a couple of days ago. And we're so privileged to have them here tonight to share Sammy J's night.
I started out on YouTube, singing a lot of different covers on YouTube. That's how I met my mates, Fortunate. So we did a lot of gigs because of YouTube. And I guess our friendship just got close over the years. We're just going to come and have some fun and listen to the music.
Genuine, and I'm I enjoyed it.
Yeah, we just got off on our set and our performance was crazy. It was fresh. The crowd was awesome and the people here just love what musicians do. So very grateful for being here. And yeah, we loved it. Thank you for having us. Fresh. Much love. Much everything.
Who is your most favorite sporting personality in all the world?
Mine's Valerie, hands down.
Sonny Bill Williams.
Sonny. Yeah, he's pretty cool.
Yeah, he's playing rugby league. He's an all-rounder kind of guy, and he's also got a tattoo all around his arm.
I'm really proud of my culture, my heritage. I can't speak Samoan. Probably know all the swear words. So I used to get in a fair few fights when the boys would say something in Samoan, thing I could understand, but I'm definitely proud of my heritage. I think that's why I got all the tattoos, just to probably getting sick of quarter Māori Samoan. Nothing against Māoris, man. Come on now. When I was about 14, my old man come back from Australia, and he come back and it was just got a tattoo. It was all wasn't too straight, so even though it was all scribbled, the guy was probably doing a tattoo like that, you know. Yeah. I did some, went down to some cherry picking, and I come back with a couple hundred dollars. I asked the old man if I could get a tattoo on my forearm, same as him, but a little bit straighter. I think I kind of greased up to him, you know. I said, oh, that tattoo look mad, you know, come on there. And sweet ass took me down. At first I got just the band on my forearm. So I had that when I was 14, and then one of my mates, one of my boys, Willie Bernard, he had the full sleeve. I was like, oh, that's pretty cool, you know, I wouldn't mind getting it just to the forearm. When I was about 20. Steve Maching in Newland, he's a really good tattoo artist, and went from there. Yeah, man, he's a man.
Keep watching for more Fresh Realness
coming up after the break.
I sleep with one eye open. Because I guess at the end of the day, you can become the best fighter, but if you don't become a decent person, that doesn't mean anything.
One punch knockout power. All fighters want to have it. Very few in the world ever have it. He has it.
Look at the power behind these punches, and Daniels is down.
Another big bomb, and Ruiz is down.
Opens in trouble.
I was introduced into boxing at the age of 7 through the love of my father. He absolutely loved the sport of boxing. He then introduced the sport into me. He forced, and I repeat, he forced me into boxing. Maybe he got beaten up when he was young.
So he thought, oh, I'll teach my son how to fight.
But there's not a day that passes that I'm not grateful and I'm thankful to my father. When we first moved into this country, he didn't see much of my dad. He used to work long hours. My mom used to work 3 jobs. 4 brothers for me and 4 sisters, and 10 other relatives living with us. So, you know, that was always tough. You know, we did the best we could. And I guess that's why when I was given the opportunity to do something decent and become whatever in boxing, the first thing that crossed my mind was to do something for my parents.
Now I can be able to buy everything that I wanted, like my family a house, buy my parents a car.
Because I guess at the end of the day, you can become a decent fighter or become the best fighter. But if you don't become a decent person, that doesn't mean anything. Yeah, I sleep with one eye open. Too many tough experiences, man. To be going through the fire and the challenging times, you know, of my life as a young fella. There were times that when these things happened, that I could have gone the other way. But I thank God for the prayers of the community and obviously my parents and families. I'm here today because of that.
I'm sad to say, but my heart is not in it anymore. I think it's time for me to try something else.
The R word didn't come to mind until the fifth, sixth round. The desire was there, then it wasn't there. The passion was there, then it wasn't there. And I believe if it's not there throughout the whole fight, then it's time for me to think about doing other things.
David Tua left the building tonight. Thank you very much.
Me and Gusman, we are very honoured and very privileged to be given an opportunity to share what we have with the Manusina. You know, the Manusina women rugby team. Recovery is so, so important. They don't have much support. Here at our humble camp too, man, we're able to contribute to their journey to hopefully do well or winning the World Cup coming up next year. So.
He's an inspiration to especially a lot of the South Auckland community, Samoan community, Polynesian, Pacific community. For us, it's, you know, we want to be at that. We want to be the best that we can be, just like David Tua.
It influences us to become that better person, and just like his quote today, you know, be better than him. You know, don't be like him, but be better than him.
Oh, it'd be interesting to see if anyone can surpass what he's done. Yeah, he's set a big example for everyone to follow. I think everyone here is really proud of him.
Where things are at, I haven't done too bad. I've been given opportunity to fight some of the greats in the game and I've done pretty good against them. And I've fought some of those who have gone and win world titles. The most important thing that I'm happy about is that my health is in place and I can still spell my name. So, just. So that's not bad for a dishwasher, man.
Some beautiful moments in sports history there. Now for some other fabulous moments, here's my favourite taxi driver, Tiger and Raa.
I'm a taxi in the daytime. I'm a hero in the nighttime. And I'm punching all the bad guys.
And welcome to the New Zealand Pacific Island Sports Awards.
There's it. I'll give it to me, baby.
Oh, Uncle.
Jeez, it's a beauty, isn't it?
Oh,
yeah,
please put your hands together for our next presenters, Tony Savay, Koza Koza, and Mino.
Thank you, boys. Yeah, well, thanks for the opportunity to present the award for Best Pacific Island Sports Person of 2013. And also, it's a very good entertainment tonight with Cindy. It's a good music tonight.
This would have been great in your day, Uncle, when you were playing sports because you were pretty mean, as eh?
Yeah, if I was playing sport now, but I'd be coming up here every 2 minutes to get an award because I'm good in everything.
Gee, bro, this is so mean. I could see heaps of celebrities. Valerie Adams,
yeah.
Oh, she's muscle.
Yeah, it is. But I like a big girl, it's a powerful girl.
And David Tua.
That last fight with the Russian guy, it's very difficult for me even to fight him, you know? I think you gotta be the same too.
I think you mean height, Uncle.
That's it. I think you gotta be the same short.
Anyway, Uncle, I felt for you when you didn't win the leadership award.
I was a little bit disappointed. I was wonder why they don't recognize me.
Now, maybe they just needed proof that you captain the Manu Samoa.
Hey, I told you. They don't have a video in those days.
I'm a taxi in the daytime. Stay tuned, guys, for some more super freshness. Coming up with your favorite artist, Pani and Pani.
You impress us with your Scott skills, and you will go through to the next round.
You dropped something.
I did.
My jaw.
Welcome back to Fresh. As you know, Pani and Pani is looking for Mr. Lavalava. Check out this week's challenge for Sky Skies of Rarotonga.
My name is Baba.
My name is Benjamin.
My name is Otu.
My name is Rex.
Oh, Mani.
Bradley Heather.
Brian Rongo.
Pedro Teo.
Patrick Arona.
I'm Mr. Lavalava.
In the search for the ultimate island warrior, there are some amazing prizes, including the chance to be the first male model of Mina Designs.
This is so good.
Hi, guys. Oh, welcome. Hey, guys.
Here you go, my darling.
So sorry about that.
Now, we all know that Pacific Islanders are renowned for their oratory skills.
They're good with their nukus, not just their pukus.
That's right. So what we want is for you to show us how you use your ukus, your words, to woo a girl.
Not woo-woo, here comes the train.
Yeah.
But woo-woo as into entice, as into address, as into connect.
Communicate.
Exactly, young. Yeah.
So, you impress us with your Scott skills, and you will go through to the next round.
If not, yeah, pass way for it.
Sayonara.
You're going home, homie.
Goodbye. Howdy, how's your family?
Yeah, see ya.
Okay, so, who wants to go first?
Okay, excellent.
So what you have here is Barnes taking on the character of, Pretty Woman. Yeah, well, times that by 1,000, that's the name of her film. Here's Bitzel.
Damn! You dropped something.
I did?
My jaw.
Papa is about to approach Mama.
How's it going?
Good, thank you.
You need something?
Do I need a something? No, I've got everything in front of me right now.
Okay.
The young Bradley, not to be confused with Bradley Cooper, I better be quiet, he's about to say something.
Hey.
Hey.
You like what you see? Would you like to touch?
Mouser is straight for the kill.
I'm a man, Steve.
Barnes, touch him. Are you gonna touch him?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay, come on. You want to come to jump on my Harley?
They don't actually have a Harley. They've got like a bazooka.
I would love to.
Big Harley, long. Jump on the back and hold this one. Yeah. Chase all the flies.
Can I hold your body?
Oh, yeah, you can hold around.
Yes. Shall we go?
When you're ready.
What a gentleman.
Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Papa, don't preach. Bond, I think, is doing some kind of call.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, thank you.
Has anyone told you that you're so beautiful? It gives the sun the reason why it's shining.
He's so cute.
Hi, I'm kind of new in town, so I was wondering, can you show me the direction to your heart?
Oh. Are you all right?
Hi.
Hi.
You look so beautiful. Oh, I've got my pop line.
Oh, well, seeing as you picked me up with your line, now you have to pick me up with your body.
Oh, the surprise was that pick her up and pick her up, actually like lifting her up.
Let's not waste any time then.
Just gotta turn into overload.
Never talk about a chick's weight. I learned that the hard way.
Pick me up with your arms.
Sweet ass.
Why not?
Good luck, may the force be with you, bro.
Jump here.
If you can lift, you will be amazing.
I was pretty much used to it as I go to the gym and I lift heavy weights, so.
He's strong.
I think you're gonna have to pick me.
I think the challenge is to pick up a girl.
Well, Bonds, it's that time to give the results.
These guys have done an amazing job, haven't they, Bonds?
They have! Amazing!
And so, you have all made it through to the next round!
But wait! We still have more challenges to come.
Look, you've brought sweetness to our ears, but now you're gonna have to bring sweetness to our eyes.
You want your legs inside it?
We need to see why you should be crowned Mr. Lavalava.
Sometime have a tsunami, come the jungle, the people help, and they can go, Pali, it's my head. That's why I took their photo on the coconut tree.
Yeah. Excellent.
keep watching for more Mr. Lavalava action next week. And also this fresh superstar that has taken on the world.
Welcome to our freshie wonderland.
A land of wonder and freshness with us freshies and our special guest.
Me, Paris Goebel. For your life, or you can know she can die. She's praying on the sun, I choose the last time around. It's a stick up, and a pick up, telling lies and telling lies, and put your face on fire. You're sexy and I know it.
That's all from us in this Pacific Sports Heroes app. Keep it fresh and stay safe over the summer. Welcome to the village.
Am I looking at this one here?
Yeah, but
today you're with some of Pacifics.
Some beautiful moments.
Islanders ripping across.
Legends of Pacifics.
This weekend she's with an
flippin' egg.
This is
ah yes!
Supporting local content so you can see more of New Zealand on air.